As you can see, everyone, Britain was hit by heavy snow in January 2010. Hello, welcome to my video blog. I'm Chris Williams. Formula One rights owner Bernie Eccleston going a bit insane. For the 2009 season, he suggested medals to replace the points system, and everyone laughed him out of court. Indeed, a few days before the season started, his medals idea was rejected. Medals, of course, being that the person who finishes first gets gold, the person who finishes second gets silver, the person who finishes third gets bronze, and everyone else gets nothing. So if you're McLaren or Ferrari, then you win all the time, whereas if you're Toro Rosso, then there's no point taking part. So it's absolutely ridiculous. But now, for the 2010 season, Bernie Eccleston has suggested that they introduce some shortcuts into the Formula One tracks, and that drivers will be allowed to use these shortcuts a maximum of 5 times during a race, and apparently it will allow drivers who are a long way behind another driver to overtake the car in front. Well, stupid. He says that he's just kind of these ideas, just trying to stimulate some ideas amongst the team owners. But medals? Shortcuts? No, ridiculous. Why do they have to tweak Formula 1 all the time? They tweaked the qualifying system a number of times. They keep changing the points. I read the other day that some are dissatisfied that there is 25 points for first and 20 points for second in the 2010 season. Right, they want there to be a bigger gap. What you mean, make it like IndyCar, so that there's only 2 drivers in it all the way through the season, taking turns to lead. Now, they're ruining Formula 1 with the points system on these new regulations. And talk about regulations. Braun GP, of course, they won in 2009 with the double diffuser, and they're talking about making it illegal for future seasons. So, innovation being made illegal. Getting rather frustrated. It says that they are more worried about how many people watch Formula 1 rather than how exciting it is. Okay, if people were to see Formula 1 for the first time, that they would have seen it by now, new people that have come along. Of course, we've now got not many manufacturers in the sport. And of course, that means we're going back now to how things used to be when I first started watching motor racing in 1988. I think US F1 will do quite well in 2010. Some people said they didn't think they're going to be on the grid, but I'm positive they will. And with Peter Windsor saying that the team has had the idea of entering for a very good number of years, I think they will surprise quite a lot of people. Shame that they're not employing Dana Kirkpatrick to race in Formula 1. She, of course, going to split her time between IndyCar and NASCAR in 2010. Right, so join me for part 2 of this themed video blog, when I will be talking about yet another Bernard. Until next time, bye for now. Bye bye.